right, the Christmas Story House is not only a staple of Cleveland tourism, it is a landmark synonymous with the holiday season. Mm-hmm.
And now, home of the leg lamp and so much more is under new ownership, and it is all thanks to a familiar face.
Yes, we're very pleased to be joined by Joshua Dickerson, who now has the keys to the iconic house. First of all, thank you for showing up. Appreciate you.
Thank you for having me.
Now, you've worked there for many, many years.
I have.
Now, how did this come about?
Well, I've been around forever since the beginning. Mm-hmm. I have friends that work there. I volunteered actually on opening day, helping, you know, bag sales, that sort of thing. And eventually started working for the company, actually in the warehouse. Worked my way up, became the CEO in 2017. And, you know, everyone knows Brian announced the sale last year, or that the house was for sale last year. And we had some serious offers, and that didn't pan out for various reasons. And he approached me with an idea. And he said, what do you think if you take an equity stake and become managing partner?
You're like, heck yeah.
Yeah, it took me about a second and a half. I'm like, yeah, let's do this, you know. And so, you know, Brian will stand to a small capacity, but he's basically going to retire. He lives in Florida. Mm-hmm. So he's basically going to retire, and I will run the day-to-day operations.
So talk about the warehouse, because I don't think a lot of people know about that. And then also the gift shop. Like, there's a lot going on over there that a lot of people may not know about.
There is. There's, you know, a whole segment of the company most people don't even know about. We obviously have the Christmas Story House and the tourism part there, the gift shop on the same complex. But we have a warehouse in North Olmsted, actually, that we do online retail. We have our own websites. We sell on Amazon, eBay, to make sure everyone in America has a leg lamp.
Yes. Well, thank goodness.
I think there was such a concern at first when it went up for sale. Everyone in Cleveland wondering what's going to happen. Is someone from outside going to come in and take over? And is it going to be the same? I met someone yesterday who said they bought all these leg lamps just in case something was going to change. But you said you would take care of this like it's another child of yours.
Oh, absolutely. I share the same concerns, especially working for the company. You know, Brian has been, even though he's not from Cleveland, has been such a wonderful advocate for Cleveland.
Yes.
And so having the opportunity to take this over and to keep it going, you know, is an awesome opportunity, and I'm really excited about it. And it's just super cool.
Now, we love it here in Cleveland, but how popular is a Christmas Story House nationwide?
Nationwide, worldwide. We get visitors from around the world. We ship lug lamps around the world. It's amazing. It's just, the popularity is huge. You know, when it was snowing just the other day, we had some people up from Texas, you know, coming to visit us, and we're super excited they got to see it with some snow, you know, so it was, it's just awesome.
I had a friend in Georgia yesterday that was in town.
Really?
Yes.
She had to go see it.
And she went and saw it.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was like her first stop, and then the cabs came.
It's so much fun.
Yeah. So what can people expect if they haven't been to the house, or are you going to make any minor changes? I think we broke the fire alarm, but that's been fixed.
Hopefully that's been fixed. Since we slept there.
This is a sleepover video.
Okay, I still can't believe you guys got to do that.
The alarm may have gone off at one point, Josh, but I think everything's under control since we left.
Yeah, everything's been fixed. Everything's okay.
The beds are intact.
That's right.
Let's talk about the Bumpus House. And I don't know if we went into the Bumpus House. Is that set up just like the Christmas Story House?
It's set up. It's kind of got a vintage feel to it. We use as many vintage pieces and accents as we could. It's kind of like an Airbnb. There's two suites there.
Yeah.
People reserve, you know,
spend
the night there. And it's a lot of fun. It's beautiful inside.
Yeah. What do you see for the future of this? I feel like the longevity of this, it will never fade.
No, and I like to think we do really well with what we do, so there's really nothing to change. You know, maintain everything, keep it pretty, and you know, keep it just as it is going forward.
How important is it to keep it Cleveland old?
To me, huge. I'm born and raised here. I love Cleveland. I love this city. So for me, it's super important. Keep it going, keep it as a beautiful icon for the city. It's wonderful.
If you're looking for Christmas gifts, head over to the shop. What do you guys have up right now?
Absolutely. You know, leg lamps, anything a Christmas story.
Yeah.
You know, we're open 7 days a week. So pop on in, and Kim, the general manager, will take care of you over there really well. And whatever you need, your Christmas story needs will be met.
And if those who want to stay at the Bubba's House, how far in advance do you have to reserve?
There's some open days. I think we're pretty booked through November, December, but visit the ChristmasStoryHouse.com. There's a link there to look at the rental suites, and pop on and see if anything's available.
Can you go sleep in the Christmas Story House
absolutely.
As well? Absolutely. That's an Airbnb as well.
Yep, a third floor loft has a, you know, queen size bed, the whole
thing. It does.
Yeah.
But I heard you have to put the soap in your mouth if you stay there. That's just part of
the... I think it's a requirement.
It's a requirement. Yes.
That's good stuff.
And order Chinese food.
Boy, I tell you, congratulations.
Congratulations. That's wonderful.
It's amazing how you just moved up through the ranks, man.
I'm very blessed. I've worked really hard my whole life.
Yes.
And, you know, it's
good for you.
Just to me, it just shows hard work really can pay off.
Yes,
amen. It's so deserving.
All right.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.
Nice to meet you.
All right.